How to handle change requests. This is one of the most important topic in current PMP. We have 110 certified PMP as of today. And all of them, especially last 40-50 PMP has said that they are receiving 15 to 20 questions of change request. Now, in the current 2021 PMP, you can have change request from two ways, agile or predictive way. So let's first discuss about what to do when a change request comes in an agile environment. It's a very simple way. Agile says that customer collaboration or contract negotiation, responding to a change or following a plan. So if a change comes, the change directly goes to product owner. This is very, very important. In Agile, it is the responsibility of a product owner to maintain product backlog, that is a list of requirement. So if a change is requested, a change is requested to development team or a scrum master, whomever it is requested, whoever has it requested, a change goes to product owner. The product owner evaluates the change. What is the value of a change? Is it a very high value change, very high value, very high risk? Or is it a medium value, is it a low value? If the change is very important, the change is so important that it can make the current sprint obsolete. For example, if you don't do that change, the current sprint or the product will become obsolete, the work will become useless. Then the product owner can even add that change in collaboration with the team into the current sprint. Yes, this is important. Only product owner can add anything into the current sprint. He will have a discussion, a trade-off with the team, like taking out some of the user stories so that to maintain the velocity. But however, he can put something into the current sprint backlog with the discussion of team. Now, if the change can wait after the sprint, product owner will add it in the product backlog, refine the product backlog as high priority, high value, high risk, and then that will become as the most important thing. If the requested change is of low priority, it will go into the product backlog and it may come into the next or the subsequent sprints. So that's very simple how you handle a change request in Agile. The change goes to the product owner, he prioritizes the product backlog according to the priority of the change. Of course, the priority is set by with the help of customer using Moscow, mostly Moscow, must have, should have, could have, would likely to have, and all those things. So this is how you handle change request in Agile. Yesterday, Fahad was recording his interview regarding his experience in PMP exam, and he said it multiple times. There were more than 5 to 6 questions regarding how to handle change in Agile in different ways. So this becomes very, very important. I hope this is easy and understandable. Now, if we come to the change in predictive environment, here things become a little bit more tricky, I would say, a little bit more complex in the context of this, that now we need to see the impact on scope, schedule, cost, and all those things. So let's say a change is requested to the PM. Now, in predictive environment, the change must be requested in change log, change form, whatever the change control procedure says. The change is requested to the PM by the customer. Now the change can be requested by the team. Let's say we call it team. It includes the resources working in the team, the stakeholders or anyone else, and customer. I am saying C. Let me use different kind of markers here. So I'm using C for customers, okay, and T for team. And let's go with that team. The team requested the change in the change log. The change comes to the PM. The PM evaluates the change. If the change is important, it is needed, and it is affecting the deliverables. If the change is not affecting the deliverables, the change is not required. So he will do analysis here. If the change is affecting the deliverable, the change will move to the next step. Otherwise, change will be rejected. Okay, and communicated to the stakeholders who has requested it. So now let's say the change is affecting the deliverable. The project manager will evaluate the change on, of course, scope, schedule, cost, quality, resource, risk, and other things. Basically, scope, schedule, cost, baselines, and other plans, how they are affecting it. This process is called integrated change. Integrated. We are looking, okay, if we change the scope, how it is going to affect the cost? How it is going to affect the schedule? Will the quality be affected? Will the resource, we have the resource to work on it? And will the risk will be affected? And things like that. So we are integrating all this change. And maybe how the procurement plan will be affected. All the plans, all the baselines will be checked here. And once he has done, project manager or the project management team has done a detailed impact analysis, they will give it to change control board. Now, of course, if they consider change is important, if no, then again we communicate. Now, the change control board can be project manager himself. Change control board has project manager himself. PM is there, sponsor is there, and senior stakeholders are there. Depending upon that, some people call this as steering committee, some people call it as change control board. I would recommend calling it as a change control board. So change control board will evaluate the change request, whether this change is minor, moderate, or major. Okay, so in other words, if the change, how much the change is affecting the baseline, depending upon the organization tolerance, how organization is risk averse, seeker, all those things, how it is affecting the scope, how it is affecting the cost, how it is affecting the schedule, all those things will be impacted. And if the change is minor, the PM can approve it himself. If the change is moderate, stakeholders and PM can approve. If the change is very high or major, I would say it's low, medium, high. And minor, moderate, major, low, medium, high. The change is very high, then you need the approval of sponsor and so on. So let's say the change is approved. If the change is approved, it goes there. Again, a diamond symbol is there. The change is approved. Okay, if it is not approved, again, you just communicate the rejected change. I'm going up. So if the change is approved, then you build the change. Means you plan all how this change will be going. Update the change log and communicate. You update the change log, build the change, communicate the change to all the relevant parties. Then you implement the change. Execution of that change. You implement the actual change. And once the change is implemented, you communicate the change to all the stakeholders. Hey, this has been implemented. And you rebalance, again communicate, and rebalance. And you keep on doing the same process. You keep on doing the same process. So this is a change request procedure when a change comes from a team or a stakeholder. Now, there is a little difference when a change comes from the customer. If the change comes from the customer, it will always be in the form of official format. So let's say the change comes to the customer. The PM will evaluate the change on scope, schedule, cost. Okay. And after evaluation, the PM will tell to the customer, hey, because of this change, the cost will increase that much. The scope will increase that much. Do you want to have that change or not? The customer will analyze the change themselves. They will say, okay, maybe the change will increase the schedule or the change will increase the scope or whatever. So when the customer said go ahead, then the project manager with the detailed analysis sent that change to the change control board, and here then the same procedure will be followed. This is how change request or change, I called it as more of a journey of change request, how change follows to the entire procedure. I hope in this short video you understand this important topic, and this will help you to clear minimum 10 to 15 questions of PMP. So if there is any question, feel free to ask. And one more thing, if you have not subscribed to our channel, do subscribe it now, because our commitment to the YouTube, to the LinkedIn is gonna rise very high, and it is possible that you are gonna miss something if you have not subscribed it yet. And do click the bell icon so that whenever we are live, whenever we upload a video, you can get notification. Till next time, live with passion and become PMP. Thank you very much.